Hello everyone, and welcome to The Sims Lore. Today, we're looking at one of Riverview's paranoid residents, Hunter Cotteneye. Don't forget to subscribe and like this if you enjoyed it. Alright, let's get into the video. So let's take a closer look at Hunter first, before we get into theories as to why he's hiding. Hunter seems to be living alone on the outskirts of Riverview at 2 Cotton Branch Drive in what appears to be an underground bunker surrounded by a chain-link fence. It also looks like Hunter has his own water supply on the property, so he's pretty much set for the end of the world. Even his property description reads, "Be prepared, you never know what the future may bring. But living underground, surrounded by concrete and chain-link fencing, is sure to bring the days ahead more promising." Inside, Hunter has all the essentials with a spacious bathroom, a living, kitchen, and dining area equipped with a bar and a fireplace. He also has a computer with internet access, speakers, a telephone, and a TV set. Funnily enough, when looking in his bedroom, there are 2 beds in there. Everything in the bunker would technically cater for 2 people, so was someone else living with Hunter? What happened to them? Maybe we can find some answers by looking at him more closely. His household bio reads, "Some people just do not play well with others. Hunter Cotteneye is one of them. He's fine with that. He would just as soon start a fight with you as he would shake your hand." So from his household bio, we know that aggression comes naturally to him, he doesn't like being around people, and just likes his space. Hunter's bio reads, "Hunter Cotteneye is hunkered down and ready for the world to come to an end. Hunter is neurotic, a loner, insane, mean-spirited, and an angler. His favorites are classical music, grilled salmon, and the color green." Due to his pretty bad traits, it's clear that Hunter had a rough childhood and developed poorly. He doesn't have any relationships, not even acquaintances, so he's completely isolated. Hunter's lifetime wish is presenting the perfect private aquarium, and he's unemployed at the start of the game, but has several skills which, if put to good use, can bring him an income. Hunter has 5 skill points in athletic, 2 in cooking, 7 in fishing, and 2 in handiness. In his inventory, he has a digital camera, his high school diploma, and a book titled The Warlock of Palladia, which I'm not sure of but might refer to The Warlock of the Firetop Mountain, an adventure single-player game book by Steve Jackson and Ian Livingstone. Hunter drives a VOM P328 truck, which is all painted in camouflage, and he also wears a camouflage outfit. Due to his insane trait, Hunter will never dress according to the event. He could be going to sleep in his formal outfit or going to a party in his underwear, which will make the host threaten to kick him out. Clearly, Hunter Cotteneye is a prepper, someone who believes the end of the world is coming in the near future and lives their life as a survivalist, stockpiling supplies and shutting the world off. Hunter is actually the only pre-made survivalist conspiracy theorist sim living a hermit lifestyle in his bunker. So all in all, Hunter is a pretty strange guy. But is there something more to his craziness? Is he onto something here? Is he trying to get away from someone? Or something? How come he lives on the outskirts of town? Riverview is a sunny, small town, peppered with farmland, green pastures, and surrounded by a twisting river. But something's not right here. If we look closely around town, there are several things that seem out of place. At the corner of the map of Riverview, on the right-hand side, there is a creepy closed-off mineshaft. If you go closer, you can see a pair of bright eyes that follow you as you move the camera. Close to the Shelley household, there is a car wreckage in the river that just looks like it doesn't belong in such a nice, quiet, small town. Are the townsfolk trying to hide something? Who does the car belong to? There's also something about the people that creeps me out. And maybe Hunter Cotteneye knows what's happening and wants nothing to do with them. Maybe Hunter knows too much, and the townsfolk have banished him on the outskirts to live a hermit lifestyle, which technically doesn't bother Hunter, and he can easily live off the land, growing plants and fishing in the river near his property. Maybe Hunter knows how Don Lothario mysteriously appeared in Riverview and who exiled him there. Or how Billy Caspian's mentor, Hank Ferdinand, mysteriously disappeared. It's also very possible that Hunter may have had company. Why would his bunker have two beds unless he was sharing that room with someone? Maybe his insane, mean-spirited trait came to good use and Hunter murdered his bunkmate. Or maybe they disappeared and Hunter knows which townie did it, and that's why he's keeping a distance. Despite its sunny, cheery look, I think Riverview holds something weird and creepy. But it doesn't end with Hunter, this is just the beginning. Stay tuned for next week's episode of the Riverview Secrets. Alright guys, there you have it, lots of info on Hunter Cotteneye from Riverview. I'd like to thank my patrons Olivia McSwain, Negative Dana, Papa Khan, Leo Thompson, Artsy Flashback, Nathan Lim, Caitlin Luigi, and Nicole Dante. Thank you guys so much for supporting my channel. That's it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. Please like the video if you enjoyed it, and let me know your theories in the comments below. Follow me on Twitter for more lore and updates. I'll see you in my next video. Bye!